What was regularly smuggled into the USA from Canada for the traditional Burns Night celebrations?
Oh, what do they have at Burns Night celebrations? Haggises?
Is the right answer.
Thank you.
We thought you might be tempted to say whiskey, but this is from 1989 up until 2010. Haggises were smuggled from Canada into America. Why might this be?
Because the Americans don't approve of inedible food coming.
This is delish.
Well, I can't say
it's that. One element inside the haggis that was contraband. There it is. What's the outer casing?
Stomach.
A sheep's stomach. And inside is...
It's called pluck. Pluck is the correct word for the bits of the heart. Is it heart, liver and...
Offal, certainly, bits of that, but one particular...
Lung.
Lungs, which is known as in the butcher's trade as the lights, which are, and those were outlawed in America because of BSE and indeed their own problems. Yes. You couldn't eat them, and so there was a trade in smuggled Canadian haggis. What do we know about the haggis? Which nation invented the haggis?
I wonder if we're not responsible.
You think it might be Danes?
It might be.
Well, actually, the first reference to it in the British Isles is actually in Lancashire. But there are lots of theories about where the haggis might come.
Offal comes from Danish. It is from the Danish word for rubbish. Offal is... there must be some hideous Scandinavian connection.
Well, there are some who think that it was Vikings who brought it over to Britain.
But it comes from Lancashire, does it?
Well, that's the first reference to it, yeah.
Do you know the Burns address to the haggis?
Yes, it's a poem.
It's a poem which on Burns night, at a Burns supper, somebody would address it, and it comes in, that's obviously been cut open, as you can see, but before it's cut, someone addresses it, and it starts with, "Fair for your honest sonsy face, great chieftain of the puddin' race, aboon them all, you tack your place, Pange, tripe or theorem, wheeler you wordy, o' grace as lang's my arm." And a pal of mine was saying... And there it is being piped in. But somebody I know was going doing a Burns supper abroad, and they had sent the address over to Germany, and it was translated into German, but the German translated it back, and the line, instead of great chieftain of the puddin' race, was translated back as mighty Führer of the sausage people.
Should stay. It's a lot better than Great Chieftain of the Pudding Race. Mighty Führer of the Sausage People. What is the date of Burns Night?
January 25th.
Yes, it's his birthday. I love the way you get all your celebrations in one corner of the year, so that being Scottish, you have like Christmas craziness and then Hogmanay insanity, Burns Night 3 weeks later, and then for the rest of the year, nothing. Just a long hangover.
Abstinence.
Durness. But there is no poet, really, that has the same level of affection in the English culture. We obviously venerate Shakespeare in different ways, and some people resent him because they're of school, but there's a deep level of love for Burns, is there not?
Absolutely. I mean, he was a great man and very forward-thinking. He was completely and utterly anti-slave trade.
Yes.
So much so that if you go to the Burns Museum, there's a photograph of Muhammad Ali, who came over to Scotland and came up and visited it because he was a student of Burns because of the humanitarian work that he had done, you know, 150 years ago. Yeah, and he loves haggis.
I remember...
I love all you sausage people, he used to say.